While the Western world mastered science and technology in the laboratories that were the monasteries and the hermitages of the Himalayas, Tibet perfected the inner sciences of the mind every bit as precise and rigorous as the methodology of science. Although all through the long period, over 1,000 years, while Europe passed through the Middle Ages, the Renaissance, the Enlightenment, and the Industrial Revolution, in Tibet, in almost in complete isolation from the rest of the world, the whole thrust of the society, night and day, was directed towards cultivating the teaching and the practice of Buddhism. A large number of people rose to extraordinary levels of mental development, and a considerable body of knowledge developed about the potential of human mind. I often find it fascinating to think how when Masons were raising the great medieval cathedrals of Europe, the Crusades were gathering momentum, and in Oxford and Bologna, the first university were being founded, the Tibet's famous poet and Saint Milarepa was singing the spellbinding songs of spiritual mastery that were to make him the inspiration of millions. When Isaac Newton was shaping the ideas that would form the basis of the centuries of science, and when Louis XIV was on the throne of France, and when Vivaldi was beginning to compose, in Tibet, the fifth Dalai Lama was carefully constructing a whole society focused entirely on spiritual practice and Buddhist values. And throughout the 19th century, age of Charles Darwin, the Louis Pasteur, and Karl Marx, with all his industrial inventions, in the east of Tibet, the great minds of the land inspired a spiritual renaissance to which many of my own Buddhist teachers were the heir. Clear?
Yes.
The result was that Tibet has a unique cultural heritage, which is part of the cultural heritage of the world. As citizens of the world, it belongs to us all. As Margot said very clearly, we will all be immeasurably impoverished if it is lost. For a start, there are great... See, then if you were to ask, but what proof do we have that the teachings that lie at the heart of Tibetan culture actually work? The answer is, for a start, there are great men and women, practitioners of Tibet, who were extraordinary living examples of both humanity and spiritual enlightenment. Look at the example of Vishwamitra Dalai Lama. To think of him and of what he has done for humanity is to find gathered and displayed in one person the greatness of the gift that Tibet is giving to the world. The teaching of Buddhist tradition of Tibet can be essentialized very simply into peace, compassion, and wisdom. These teachings contain extraordinary understanding of mind and complete methodology, in fact, of working with and mastering our mind and emotions. So I just began with that. So let's then get talking.
That's wonderful. Thank you.